come through, Queen. I wanna see ya come through, Queen.
Hi, everyone. It's Dan.
And Brendan.
And this is Come Through Queen.
Hi.
Hi, Brendan.
What's up?
I mean, we're just like really on one right now. We had, I would say, our barn burner pre-show and Patreon bonus episode discussing Housewives' iconic moments.
Oh, my God. A barn burner.
So not everyone's a barn burner.
Yeah.
But some of them are. And this would be two barn burners in a row. And this could be, we could be completing the barn burner trifecta right now in main episode.
We're going to need a new barn.
Where are we going to plant the crops?
Oh, my God.
Okay.
I don't think you plant them in the barn. You plant them outside of the
Where
barn.
Where are we going to store the tools for the crops?
Exactly. Okay. Farming by Come Through Queen. okay. First of all, speaking of farming relationships, children, Lindsay Hubbard is having a girl.
I don't know. For me, in my brain, you know when you just have like the vibe and like they do when they play the game of like, what's it going to be at the reveal? Like, I just like felt like she was having a boy.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know what it was.
I see her as girl mom.
You see her as girl mom.
You know why?
Why?
It's her and our friend Honey.
Oh.
They are the same.
Oh, I see.
Two girl moms.
I thought you were going to go down the path of like, oh, maybe she's going to like be able to like repair the trauma from like her and relationship with her mom.
I was not going to go there.
Hub.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
But fun. Okay, other... trauma.
Fun. No, you love trauma.
Yeah,
come on.
This is a podcast about trauma.
Rage and trauma.
So other Summer House stuff that I just wanted to like touch on. No big news, but as somebody who follows the dolls, I've just noticed a couple things. Okay, first of all, West seems to be doing a lot of traveling in places that aren't the Hamptons.
I don't like it one bit.
Yes.
And like now that we have an eye on West, it's like when we know he's not there one weekend, we know he's like at the MLB All-Star game.
MLB, he was like at like fucking In-N-Out. I don't know.
He's posting like grid carousels with like all these other friends.
Yeah.
Sir, your friends are on TV with you.
Exactly. No, but he's like making the rounds like in like, I don't know, like TikTok circles. He appears with like this guy from TikTok sometimes.
I gotta say, I sat through him, the guy, and Jesse, and the other guy talking about Southern Charm.
Oh, I'm talking about a different guy.
But for 20 minutes talking about Southern Charm, I was glued to it.
Oh, well, yeah. It's the long history of Wes doing the videos where he learns about different shows on Bravo.
Yeah.
And now Jesse Solomon was a part of it.
Which couldn't ask for a better person to join.
Yeah. I also wanted, speaking of Jesse Solomon, I do want to say that I mentioned this last week that Jesse Solomon was promoting the Fresca hard seltzer thing with Andy in the Hamptons.
Okay.
But now, West is promoting some sort of Captain Morgan canned beverage.
What the fuck?
This is...
The crime that Hannah Burner alleges was why she was iced out?
And the crime that, like, is why Kyle might be mad at Craig.
Crimes abound.
Well, it's not really a crime now that all the boys are doing it. And the fact that the boys are getting away with it and Hannah Burner was not getting away with it.
It just shows... It's not a woman's world.
It's misogyny at work.
It's a misogyny world.
And of course, Kyle is the number one misogynist.
No.
Yes.
Rewind. Remember how hot he was in that DJ picture?
Okay, one photo.
Summer. What a time.
What a time.
It's one of the seasons.
The fun thing about Summer House is it's now getting enough press and stuff that like...
It's easier to keep eyes and ears.
We're talking about them now.
It's like the Roni days.
Exactly. But it's like even more than the Roni days because doesn't it feel like now between like the press and like the social media accounts, like everyone's like embedded with them.
With Summer.
With like, yeah.
Okay.
It's like a hop, skip, and a jump from like a Page Six reporter actually being at that party.
Okay. Okay, I see it.
Yeah. Speaking of parties, let's go over to the biggest party on CBS, which is Big Brother.
Okay. So here's the thing about Big Brother. It's like, we're now starting it after weeks of like people being annoying about Love Island online.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, ugh, you're all so annoying right now. And then once I'm like sitting there on my couch watching Big Brother, I'm kind of like, who am I to judge? Because this is such a stupid show.
Oh, that's why I never judge what other people watch.
I know, you can't yuck people's yums, because I'm watching this fucking AI binge who looks like...
Call her by her name. Her name is Ainsley. Ainsley.
Who looks like... I don't know if you remember that cartoon from like the late 90s, early 2000s of like... It was like 3D. I think they like... It took place like in a video game The graphics for this cartoon were so horrible. That's what this looks like.
It's really wild because, like, I can do more talented work using, like, the Bing app on my phone.
What is going on? Why is this the image?
I don't know. It's like classic CBS, classic Big Brother.
Sloppy. It's always so sloppy.
I will say, I feel like... It hasn't come out on the actual show yet how messy the actual house is right now. But from the feeds and the clips that I'm seeing online, people are comparing it to early Big Brother.
So here's the problem with Big Brother, like, when we're at this stage of the game, is that up until last night, we only had the two premiere night episodes where we're just meeting our new friends. And, like, those are nothing. Those are, like, people screaming at the camera, like, acting when, like, a key shows up, like... under a towel by their pool in their backyard.
Yeah.
So, like, we're not really, like, getting to the meat and potatoes yet. And then, like, last night, we finally get, like, a supersized episode.
I feel like you've been watching too much, like, cable news. Meat and potatoes?
Okay. So, the problem when I'm watching last night's episode is the discourse online is, like, everyone knows these people at this point as if they're, like, lifelong family members, old friends. And, like, I've got, like... three people's names down pat.
Well, Angela.
Angela, of course, the queen.
Tucker.
Tucker. Who? Imagine going from like, in like the lead up to the show, I was like, everyone's like, he's so hot. To now I'm like, what is this abstract art I'm looking at?
Now people are like, it's turned a corner where now people are comparing him to, in energy, to Jack Schlossberg.
Okay, I'm seeing it. It's Schlossberg in. I'm seeing it.
So, like, that's, like, Little Edian.
Okay.
And then I like what's her name? The blonde, who kind of reminds me of Brittany Haynes. Because she seems like she'll be funny.
Leah. She was in the final three for the HOH competition?
Sure. I'm not... I only have time for Angela, really.
I mean, I focus on Angela. Like, the fact... Okay, so Angela is... the 50-year-old grandmama on the show. And she's annoyed that people are calling her mama, but she's rolling with it. She is paranoid, freaking out at every turn. She is not cut out for this reality world.
She has this, like, bone to pick with this guy, Matt.
She's being a little creepy with him, like sidling up to him, like, first day being like,
you're going
to
be in a showmance.
You're
going
to be in a showmance. You're so fucking hot. You're going to be in a showmance. It's like, grandmama, please relax.
It's kind of giving Yolanda of Selena fame.
Oh my God. My mind was racing. I was like, Yolanda Hadid, Yolanda Pfister. I didn't land Yolanda from Selena.
Yes, it's giving
Yolanda Pfister.
Scottish twink.
She is giving Scottish twink. And the fact that she has the power right now is beautiful. I want every challenge henceforth to be catered to her and her strengths.
Yeah.
Because she's not going anywhere in my book.
Yeah, I mean, she's going to be gone in, like, 2 weeks, unfortunately.
No, you better get out of here.
I'm knocking on wood.
No, because, so the super fans, they hate, like, the main producer. I think her name is, like, Allison Grodner. And they always, like, say she's, like, cooking the books.
Yeah.
Right? I need her to cook the books for Angela.
Yeah.
You know?
Do you think I still have the whatever program to watch feeds?
Paramount?
Do you think I still have that?
I don't. That has lapsed for me, so I don't know about you.
I know I had it at one point to watch Drag Race.
Oh, yeah, but we don't do
and
that.
And more importantly, to watch Real World Homecoming.
Yeah, we don't do... Well, that doesn't exist anymore. They stripped it from the platform, I know. In fact.
We will continue to watch Big Brother until...
Until we decide we're not going to watch it.
Until we decide we won't. I will say... Recently, we've stuck through. Not last summer as much, but the two summers before that, we stuck through.
No, we stuck last summer, didn't we?
Not as much, though.
I think I did and you didn't.
Yeah. Last summer was Jag. Before that was Taylor.
Oh, yeah.
Before that was Xavier.
Yeah. That was three great seasons in a row.
Sure, yeah.
Okay. Shall we go to Dubai?
Let's go to Dubai. I'm worried.
About?
Caroline Brooks.
Oh, well, every week... is a cause for concern, really. No, I think I've actually circled back into being excited about Caroline Brooks.
She is giving unpredictable.
She's giving sinister.
Staubian.
Yes. She is the heir to the Staub legacy.
It fits in a way. It's like everyone's hanging out and getting along without her. Mm-hmm. It's not as intense because they're still inviting her to things.
But she still has Dr. Sarah Soldier.
Yeah. Which that's... Is that who you want?
And then she found a nail tech to bring. It's that Jonas Wifeian. Wasn't it that one wife?
Oh, the first wife.
Danielle, I think her name
is. Yeah, Kevin's wife.
Yeah, wasn't she a nail tech before?
I think so, yeah.
Great. So she brought a Danielle to...
Do they still live in Jersey? Yeah, they must.
I think the whole family is like... It's like, you know, the Kennedys are in Massachusetts, the Jonases are in Jersey.
Yeah, North Jersey.
Yeah. Okay. Ayan... We're focusing on her a little bit more this week. Ayan Beauté.
I know. And we're also just like, we're more with Ayan's family this year.
I like that.
Which I like. She even brought her brother to Stanberry's housewarming.
Oh, you know, Ayan fell, we're not there yet, but Ayan fell into the background during the housewarming.
And we talked about that a little bit last week too. It feels like she is kind of like falling to secondary character this year, which is fine for now. Mm. Because she still brings what we want her to bring.
Yeah. Okay. So, Chalene, like, kind of dragging the event was silly to me because she's like, this is for makeup? Like, what is this? But, like, what do you, like, this is a runway. Like, do you want them, like holding makeup brushes and, like, beating their face with it as they walk down the runway?
Right.
No, we're showcasing the beauté on the beautiful people.
Yeah. That's right? Like the point, right?
I think so, yeah.
You're supposed to be able to like identify the makeup.
And then everyone being like, oh, I'm so proud of Ayan. Blah, 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 blah. And then Brooks being like, her little sob self, being like, I'm proud of Tony, which I guess it's like Tony something, like Ayan Beauty by Tony, whoever. And I'm proud of Tony for throwing this event together. And then Ayan Beauté by Tony, whoever.
Yeah, also Brooks was late.
Yeah.
Some things off.
Mm. Then we have like the three girls.
Mm-hmm.
It was Lisa, Brooks, and Dr. Sarah. And like the way Dr. Sarah kept talking about just coming from work. What is work?
Praying. Right?
Oh, she is. She has been put in charge of the prayer for Eat, Pray, Party. And that no one's interested in.
Oh, my God.
That was fun for me. Okay. It feels like Lisa got, like, a scene to combat. Is there a problem at home?
Right?
With the husband?
Yeah. What's his name again?
It doesn't stick with me. And, like, I used to think he's hot, but then, like, I think it's fading for me a little bit.
He just, like... has a nice haircut usually.
Yeah, he's kind of giving me nothing.
And her like trying to do the thing being like, oh, you get more pedicures than I do and like all that kind of stuff on camera. And he's like, oh,
that's my wife. Okay. Okay, now this is what gagged me.
Okay.
It comes up during the three-girl lunch. Brooks, and then gets to Lisa, and then gets back from Lisa to Talene. Brooks calling Talene a beggar. I had me laughing and laughing. She was begging to be on the show, begging to hang out with me, begging to be this event, begging to be at that event. And when they showed like her in the background of all the events,
mm-hmm.
I was gagging.
So you're saying that she is a beggar.
But I think it's a two-way begging street, because the closing line delivered iconically, much like Danielle Cabral.
You wore my wardrobe or whatever.
You begged for my wardrobe like all last season.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, this is a two-way street. Like, I'm using you, you used me, bitch.
Exactly.
Okay. There was a montage, like, I don't know if it's like during the housewarming or getting ready for the housewarming, of Sergio calling Stanberry honey. And it was giving me Beyonce pure honey.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, honey, Miss Honey.
Oh my God. It was because Talene brought those like ugly pillows, and one of them said, like, this is like honey's house, or like, the house of honey.
It's giving pure honey. Wow.
Ooh, like that's, I like Talene a lot, but like she needs to learn how to give a housewarming gift. Because those pillows aren't it.
Okay. Brooks walking in with the sage. Love that too.
It's,
No, it's just like, she's such a, like a villain.
Yeah, but it's like, okay, some of it hits and some of it doesn't. It's like all so calculated.
Okay. I think now, Patreon bonus, we're talking about most iconic moments. Maybe this is not quite there yet, but like, I don't know who said what, but it was Talene and Brooks fighting, and one of them's like, drop it, drop it. And then when the other one says, drop your drink,
mm-hmm.
I was gagged.
Yeah.
That is so clever.
Yeah.
You're slurring, drop your drink. When someone's telling you to drop it?
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God.
Well, yeah, but then they ended up both accusing each other of, like, drinking too much. Yeah. And I'm like, well, like, the origin of, like, what you're fighting about was because you were both drunk at Beyonce.
Yeah, to get you drunk together.
Yeah.
And then the husband's getting into it. And then when Talene's like, you don't have a husband.
Ooh.
Oh, my God.
I just think also the interesting part of it was the Dubai politics of it all.
We're going to get arrested.
And like how, and you could even see, like you hear Sarah talk about it in her confessional, but then even just the way production is acting is so
nervous.
Different
yeah.
than any other city.
I mean, production's acting as if we came to blows.
Yeah.
And it's nowhere close to that.
Yeah, and it is just also interesting how cognizant Stanberry is about it, too.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
She's like to Sergio, like, don't
sit
get
down.
Involved.
Yeah. I kind of say, Stanberry, I was like, I think I was sour on her for season one.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think she was like playing the game. She felt like asleep at the wheel.
Yeah, then I think what might have happened, I think she liked the idea of like the Bravo thing, and then season one happened and she filmed it and she like didn't remember like the glory, and then like she got like a gut punch going into season two, being like, oh, this is like fun being famous again, and Bravo's like so much more elevated these days, even though this is like a low low rated show. And I think she decided to like amp it up. Even her fucking hair is like,
oh my God, she is serving C.
Truly.
I think she thought for season one, she could just do what she did in Ladies of London.
Yeah.
Which is just like her existence was enough. And like now she's like bringing a little bit more.
Yeah. But I will say like the more that she's bringing doesn't feel put on at all. Like what Caroline Brooks is doing feels put on.
Mm.
Caroline Stanberry, it just feels like she's like
au naturel.
Au naturel, leaning in a little more. And just like she has that star power, like even when they were all sitting on that ledge with the pool earlier, and like I think Ayan in her confessional was like, I'm going to just try not to laugh too much at Caroline Stanberry's joke so that Lisa doesn't get mad.
I do love the like shifting dynamics this season.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's Dubai.
That is Dubai. Do you like Stanberry's house?
Not really.
I kind of like it.
It's kind of like we're throwing stones in a glass house.
Yeah. I also think it's like interesting, just the real estate in general in Dubai. There's a lot of, it seems like there's a lot of those like, not row houses, but houses that are connected in a way that they aren't in other cities that we watch on these shows.
I mean, it's just like such a luxe house, like with a $50,000 couch, and like, we're like on top of your neighbor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, who am I to talk? I can see. Yeah. I can see in the apartments of five people.
I'm connected.
And I'm sure these people can hear me say,
oh, yeah, worse.
Whatever
they're
I'm saying.
They're listening to Come Through Queen right now. Live. They're like they're the first ticket holders of Come Through Queen Live. Okay. Shall we go to Orange County?
Yeah.
Wow. Who would have thunk Dubrow's party would last as long into this episode as it did?
I know.
I thought we were like wrapping it up.
Me too.
But we've got, like, Shannon and Alexis, like, are, like, screaming at each other. And then we, like, full circle to Alexis, like, making a New Year's resolution of, like, repairing a friendship with Alexis, with Shannon.
I know. I loved the moment of, like, Shannon, like, overhearing Alexis, like, yapping. Mm-hmm. And Shannon's like, can you quiet down, please?
Yeah. Glam by Pam as well.
Glam by Pam. I mean, we're doing that like booth where like the wind sends things all around that they do on The View a lot, actually.
The way that we're like, we're all laughing and laughing about Jen Pedranti not having money, like all together as a community. I'm talking about like on the show, like they're all just like, oh, she needs the money for like her car payment. And Jen's like, yeah, but give me the money.
She is a good sport.
She's so good.
She's so beautiful.
Stunning.
Inside and out.
But here's a gag though. Here's a gag. I know this is like later in the episode when she's like thanking the dad for like taking care of her at 46. I would have never landed on 46. And I'm not saying she looks older, and I'm not saying she looks younger. I'm merely saying, like, she's of the, like, Orange County beauté, where it's, like, an ageless beauty.
Sure. Dan, I also think there's a thing.
Oh.
As we age.
Oh.
As we, so as I, oh. I just turned, I went from 40 to 37.
Okay, yeah.
And now that you're 40, it's like, it is weird to be
Pierce
within striking distance of these women in this way. Mm-mm. And not to say, I mean, we've obviously had people who are our peers and younger, like Ashley Darby comes to mind. But like now that we're like,
well, we've been doing the podcast for 8 years, right?
I was in my 20s.
Yeah. But back then we were always like, a housewife must be over 40. And it's like, oh no, here I am. There.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We were like, oh my God, not another 30-year-old.
Yeah, but then age looks different on people.
Mm.
Oh, do you get those? You're not on TikTok a lot, but do you get those like high school reunion ones where they show the yearbook photo and then they show them at their high school reunion?
No.
Oh, it's so fun.
Send me that instead of that Minnie Mouse girl.
Oh.
You're always sending her.
Amy?
I'm not interested in her. Enough.
No, it's so fun because then it's like, then you go and, well, it's actually a fun game because then you're like, you see them when they're in high school, then you're like, oh, did they age well or not?
Mm.
And then you go to the comments and everyone's commenting, oh, like, Barnaby looks great
or
whatever.
No.
Yeah.
Not Barnaby.
Okay, so back to Jen Pedranti.
Beautiful woman. We're still at the party.
Oh. Shannon goes into the hallway.
Oh. Tamara's giving actress.
Yeah.
The way she speaks, she's like, I just, like, you hurt me, Shannon. It just, like, she doesn't sell it at all.
It's also just so funny, just, like, her miscalculation.
Mm.
And, like, on paper, she went where, like, you would expect to go. Like, I'm like, if I'm looking on paper, okay, this person got a DUI, with their dog in the car. They ran into a house. I'm not going to be nice to them. I'm going to go the other way. Yet the world is rallying around Shannon.
I mean, and like, I feel like I'm learning more details now that are still shocking to me, that she went home.
Yeah.
Because her phone was there.
And then she came back. And she says that she came back, like, she says the reports that she pretended to be walking Archie are wrong. She came back with Archie to admit to the police what she had done.
Mm.
And maybe I believe her.
Okay. Okay.
Maybe not.
But at the same time, I gotta say, like, her when they were, like, practicing flag football, Shannon, like, apologizing to Gina was such a beautiful moment.
She's good at apologizing.
As a Gina fan, it was just good to see that.
Yeah.
Gina had, like, an episode for the history books, I would say.
Gina was feeling herself.
Gina at work. Welcome to your new home.
Oh, my God. As somebody, like, I know you sometimes work in that space. Did she do a good job?
Yes, I'm buying it. I'm buying the home. Okay. I think there's a lot to talk about here in terms of, like, the Gina-Jen feud.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Gina is not legally responsible for anything that, like, is happening with Jen.
Okay.
Let's get that straight first. Right? So, like, the fact that Jen, that like, Gina vouched for her, like, no one's coming after Gina now.
But, I mean, reputation. Taylor Swift.
Big reputation.
Taylor Swift did a whole album about reputation.
Now, this is, like, what's not clicking for me. When Gina starts talking about, I had this listing that I'm trying to sell, and she cost me $50,000 because an agent wouldn't get back to me. This agent who has access to cash buyers, and then I lost this deal for $50,000. It's like, I'm sorry. If this other agent had a buyer who wanted to buy this home, they're going to bring it and buy the home,
right,
and earn a commission. Like, they're not going to not bring a buyer because you fucked up vouching for someone who couldn't pay their rent.
Right.
This is a sale, not mm-hmm. a rental. We're not like, oh, you didn't bring a landlord or a tenant to, like, make this deal together.
Right.
Someone's either going to buy the house or not going to buy the house. It's not like, oh, I'm worried about you paying rent for, like, a year or whatever.
Yeah.
So what are you talking about that she, like, killed this deal for you? There was no deal if the buyer was not brought. Like, who's to say they brought a buyer?
So she's making shit up.
She's just, like, overblowing this, like, $50,000. Like, to me, this $50,000 thing is, like, nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
But I am loving her rolling up to the bakery in her train conductor hat, roasting a beautiful Jen Pedranti.
I know.
Showing up too beautiful for Gina's taste.
And Jen gets that in her confessional.
Jen taking a shot at Gina's fast looks.
Jen being a scholar of this show enough to take that shot.
We're so back, baby. It's so good. I'm, like, dying.
And it's, like, all, it's, like, so, I mean, the Shannon stuff is high stakes, but, like, most of it is, like, so low stakes that it's, like,
well,
we're having fun.
Until, what's Jen's fiance's name? Ryan?
Ryan. I, like, yeah, it was, remember, because the other Jen was Jen and Ryan, yeah, and now we're Jen and Ryan.
Ryan. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Until we get into, like, $1 million fraud situations.
I know. We're not there yet, though.
The stakes are so low.
I did like spending time with Katie's family.
Oh, and, like, yes, we got to meet.
Getting to know the dots.
I feel like we learned a lot of information, but then also, this was a situation where I need an infographic.
Okay, I think I know. Okay. Oldest daughter from
one man.
All of her children are from two people.
I don't think so.
Yes.
Oh.
she laid it out on her Instagram story.
Oh.
Yeah, so the oldest children.
So she understood that people were confused.
Yeah, so one of the kids, I think Max is his name, lives in Georgia with the original dad, mm-hmm. who is parent to that child, the oldest daughter, and the one who stayed in San Francisco to finish school.
Yes.
Stayed in...
She has four children. One daughter, two boys, and a young... And then we'll get to Bandon.
Bandon, yeah. So, yeah. So, that's why they're... That's. It sounded like it was, like, for some reason, like, four different fathers.
To me, it sounded like the one father of the girl, a father of the two boys... And then current father of the youngest boy.
Maybe that's it.
I think that might be it.
But I think she laid it out on Instagram and it wasn't that. I think it's three in one.
Because the way she described the daughter's relationship with the father is as if like that man disappeared.
Mm.
Like he is not in the picture. So the for one son to be living with him... Well, that's still in a picture.
Yeah, I could be wrong, but I feel like I came out of her explaining it on her Instagram story thinking I knew
it
was.
I'm clearing that up for you.
Well, no, the fact that she had to clear it up is the situation. But yeah, I mean, like they let one of the kids finish his schooling alone in San Diego.
Mm.
So they have lived in Georgia, San Diego, and then now OC.
Okay.
And then Bandon.
Okay, now Bandon. As a Brendan, I'm sure you have a lot to say about this.
Well, as a Brendan who grew up in the South, I was always called Brandon by well-meaning Southerners.
That's interesting. So, like, so Brandon is more Southern then.
Yeah, because Brendan is very Irish Catholic, and
we're looking Northeast for that.
Exactly. There's not. I mean, when I was growing up in the '90s and early 2000s, there weren't a lot of like. Catholics where I'm from basically also
in Georgia.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was weird to be Catholic when I was growing up.
Sure. Huh. Has Catholicism spread in Georgia now?
I think so. My impact.
Your impact. Wow. You really spread the good word. wow. Okay. And then, so that leaves us with Bandon.
No. Yeah. We're back. So yeah, Bandon. And it's a name that people have.
Oh.
I Googled it to make sure that it wasn't the first I was ever
hearing this. Where does it land on the Social Security list?
Oh, I didn't find that.
Google? Like
Bandon?
Google Social Security name popularity list, and then you can search by name.
Okay.
Because when we were landing on Simon... We were like, we want something that's like...
Number one?
Well, Simon is number one in our hearts.
Sure.
But we want something that was like, you know, you don't see every day.
Do they have a search here?
Yeah, they do have a search. By name.
Okay, baby names.
Yeah.
Watch our video countdown. Oh, popularity name.
Yeah,
oh, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
They hit it. 2000 and later. Okay, go.
Bandon
is not in the top 1,000 names for any year of birth beginning with 2000.
So Katie's like a trendsetter, or correct. Laying the groundwork for the trend.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see Brendan. Oh, we don't have to.
No, let's see it.
2023, 885.
885?
Yeah.
Shut up. That's really low.
Well, I'm unique.
You don't see a Brendan every day, I guess.
You don't. I'm going to go from 1980 to
mine
and see what... So 87 was my year.
Aren't you obsessed with this now?
Isn't 156.
So so you fell off.
No, well, yeah, but it peaked in 1999 at 96.
Mm.
I'm glad it peaked.
I can't believe in like modern day Brendan has fallen to the wayside.
Oh, it's getting worse and worse and worse.
It's just like you really have some cleaning up to do.
You know what? Thank God.
Okay.
I mean, do you want me to look at Dan?
my birth name's not Dan. It's Daniel, baby. No, we're
17 in 2023.
Yeah.
Oh, Yeah, you're a common bitch.
But like, I feel like of the common girls, it's like Daniel's like the cutest.
You're 83.
Yeah.
8.
I know. My parents actually like.
Of the common girls, Daniel's the cutest?
It is, because it's like, you don't just, it's just like a little weird. IEL? Like, who thought of that? No, so my parents, it's no surprise that I'm number 8, because my parents wanted to buck the trend of naming me after my dad's father.
Okay.
So they were like, oh, Daniel instead. Right. Instead of Joseph.
Oh.
So I'm Daniel Joseph.
Okay.
Okay. Anything else about OC you want to talk about?
No.
Okay. Let's talk about New Jersey.
Speaking of Joseph.
Speaking of Joseph, you can't walk a block without tripping on a Joseph in Jersey.
Did you catch the new commercial for Rao's?
Now, let me tell you how great. And like endorsements.
I was kind of surprised because I feel like up until a couple years ago, like Rao's was trying to pretend like it was like a more exclusive brand.
Oh, okay.
But now it's.
I mean, I don't know like the trajectory of Rao's, but like maybe it's been bought.
I think it probably has. I mean, it's still like if you go to a grocery store, it's still on the expensive side of like a jar of pasta.
Yeah.
And like you can just make your own.
Oh, please. It's truly Medigan to be buying the jar of pasta sauce.
Well, I know that's what you say. That's the Gorgas.
Well, I mean, they're trying to prove it wrong. They're trying to prove it's not Medigan.
Mm-hmm.
do you know what Medigan is?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure.
You say it all the time.
All right. Well, just in case for the listeners who don't hear it every day, it's like Italian's way of saying something is like American. Like it's Medigan.
I think with context clues, everyone probably figured that out.
Okay. So sound off the comments below if you have the context clues available to you. Okay. So that's Gino Gorga. You couldn't pay him to be excited, could you?
Dad, is that the Rao?
And his TikTok hair.
I don't know. I think I like him better than Gia.
Well, I like anyone better than Gia.
Oof.
Oh, God.
Well, I mean, we're going to have to watch her on another show soon.
We're going to be making it real soon. In Manhattan.
Do you think they'll do, like, a Thunderpuss remix of, like, New York, New York for that, like, theme song?
Huh.
Because, like, if you can make it anywhere, or if you can make it here, you can make it anywhere.
Or let's do, like, an Alicia Keys, New York. Concrete jungle.
That song was on recently, and I was with my mom. She's like, I love this song.
Oh my God. Make her a music critic. Editor in chief of Pitchfork.
Well, you know, I mean, like, you know, I told the story about how I turned her on to Chapel Roan recently, too. Yeah.
She said, this is better than Gaga.
She said, better than Gaga.
Okay. Jurors, this is Jurors Day. I gotta say, Danielle Cabral, professional.
Mm-hmm.
For building bridges with Fuda. For being willing to show up anywhere, anytime, any place.
I have to say, watching, I feel like it's not gonna last because I feel like she's gonna fuck it up. But like watching her and Fuda together, I'm like,
I believe the children are our future.
Teach them well and let them lead the way.
Yes. Oh my God.
Whitney said, when Whitney was writing that song, probably in New Jersey, because in her house, that now gay people own. Do you know that?
Oh. Shall we go?
Well, I know people who go. Did you know this?
No.
I don't know if I'm supposed to say this.
Okay. Well, then you could tell me after.
Okay.
Can we go?
I mean, maybe.
Okay. I want to go to Whitney's house.
Okay.
Wow. A New Jersey landmark. Come on. We're getting a lot about, like, this lawsuit with, like, Louie's ex and Marge's involved. Like, this is where we're losing me.
And then, like, fucking Teresa is pulling a card from Alexia's book, and we're going to invite her lawyer over for a chat with the girls, which is next episode.
James Leonard.
Yeah. He's been in our lives for a long time, right?
I mean, much like Donna Marco is main cast, James Leonard is main cast.
Is he related to Stu of the grocery stores? Stu Leonard?
Who?
Do you know Stu Leonard?
How do I know who I am?
Well, you know the grocery store like Stu Leonard? Or is it called Joseph Leonard? No, it's Stu Leonard.
What the fuck?
It's like where they have like the little, it's like in Connecticut.
No.
And like other places, they've got like the little dancing things on the top of the shelves.
No. In New York, we had ShopRite.
Okay.
We had Key Food. We had, those were the main girls.
Okay. Well, as somebody who has traveled up and down the Eastern Seaboard and even up and down the Western Seaboard, I know different grocery stores.
You know
stores.
A Piggly Wiggly.
Yeah, I know a Piggly Wiggly. You know a Wegmans. A Market Basket. A Shaw's.
Mm.
What are the ones out? Out west.
Oh God, Erewhon.
Erewhon, yeah.
Now, Fessler's running around in circles.
I can't really pinpoint her. I used to think I knew her.
You and she. Who was it? Was it Marge who was like, you two are of, or it was like Marge Dolores who was like, you two are of different generations. Like, this is not a friendship meant to be. Like,
of Fuda and
yeah.
Fessler?
Like, yeah. Like Dolores and Marge were like, you're our peers. Like, let Danielle and Fuda be friends.
I know.
Okay.
It's like Tiny Toon Adventures. We've got like, Bugs teaching.
Ah, yes.
And teaching Buster. Babs and Buster.
Oh, my God. I cannot wait to watch Tiny Toons Adventure, How I Spent My Summer Vacation with My Son. One of the greatest films of all time.
Great.
Are
you going to be like one of those like parents who only shows the classics?
I mean, we're going to like try to not show anything for as long as we can. And then... I mean, I'm not going to show Coco Melon.
Yeah, but there's like the people, like there's the people who only show like classic Sesame Street, classic like Snoopy.
Well, like let's start with that and then like grow out from there.
Well, from what I know, from what I hear, everything now is too fast.
It is very fast. Well, actually, I like on a similar note, I had the thought of like, how am I going to introduce my son to video games? It's like, do we go, maybe we go from Nintendo, regular Super Mario... And we work our way through the classics.
Most parents are like, I never want to introduce my children to video games.
See, that's where I differ. It's like
you got to pass down the traditions.
Well, he's got quite the collection he will be inheriting.
He has to pick up the podcasting mic for your gaming podcast to continue it.
But to me, like video games, like, I'm not talking like Call of Duty, pew, 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 like kill, let's kill each other. I think a lot of good video games like teach like problem solving skills.
Yeah.
Teach. I mean, like I played a lot of like story based games.
Yeah.
Learned a lot of empathy.
Grand Theft Auto Online teaches you imagination because you run around.
Mm.
And you have to like make up yeah. your own game.
Oh my God.
You also have to find your way around. Also, if he's ever going to visit LA,
oh my God,
it's helpful to know the map.
It is helpful to know. Okay. Now, we had Girl So Confusing Remix Part 1 with Bethany and Luann. I fear Part 2 was this very episode. With Teresa and Jen talking about how they ride for each other.
Oh my God.
Right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. When I look at Jen's relationship with Teresa, I'm
it's
like...
It's loserish.
Teresa's never going to emotionally fulfill her.
Like, look at how much fun you had with the dolls.
I know. Like, having a Cosmo with Zia Melis.
Yeah. I love when they were like... We pretend to love each other, and then, like, we trick ourselves into thinking we do. I gotta say, Slumber Party was great.
Yeah. Jackie and her dogs.
Jackie can't win. When Jen Aiden, maybe, asked about how the book is doing.
Yeah.
And Jackie unprovoked says, well, it's not a New York Times best bestseller. I thought it was just like easy to get a New York Times bestseller. Not like, I guess not everyone could do it like Teresa. Doll, just say like, it's doing great.
Yeah.
Not this like humiliation kink that I Jackie know. Has this season.
And then she's like standing there in the slippers talking about how big her feet are. And Marge gets in the, oh yeah, I told you people had hooves or whatever.
Oh my God. I think Marge got a whack from the little lipstick reader.
Yeah.
Of like how many years she's been on this earth.
Oh my God. I went to a thing that had a lip reader, but we didn't do it.
I've never heard of this before. This is something new?
I'd only heard about it. I went to a condom party during Pride Month.
When did you... You didn't ever tell me about this.
I think I did. And one of the activations was, like, this lip reader. We didn't end up doing it because it just, like, I looked back and it felt too intimate. It could have been the same girl.
Okay.
Tri-state area. Hello.
I just had so much fun at the slumber party.
I know. The fruit by the foot.
Oh, my God. Jen Aiden Victor.
Yeah. And then Zia Melissa's like, actually, I won.
Oh, yeah. Zia. But Zia looked cute.
They all looked cute.
She always does, yeah.
I mean, the Fuda getting like a flower wall. It's like, how much money did you spend on this fucking party?
It's like the olden days of them spending their whole check.
Yeah. Ugh.
Okay, what is cooking? Because I know we only have like 2 episodes left.
So what's cooking is the house in the Berkshires that they were supposed to film at, but it burned down, remember?
Yes.
We were supposed to have a Dorinda cameo, another one.
Oh my God, yes. I was like, why are we talking about this trip? And the house burned down.
The house burned down.
It's truly like emblematic of where this franchise is going.
And I think like when it burned down, we, the audience, were like, can't Dorinda just move him in?
I know, we've done it before. We can do it again. But she hosted a whole friggin' season of a show.
I know. I think the whole season took a lot of preparation. Mm. But it's like, can't you get like a fucking crew in there to clean, turn some linens over, like cook, buy decorate, some rosé. Like,
make it nice.
Come on.
Oy, oy, oy.
Oy, oy, oy.
So I had my eyes and ears open because I lost track and like time is a social construct. I thought the next episode could be the finale, but no, we have 2 more left.
Yeah.
And then our something else, which we'll get to in a moment.
Oh, yeah.
With that being said, shall we do a Freak of the Week of the One True Queen?
We shall.
Our Freak of the Week. My. I love when the chickens come back to roost.
Mm-hmm.
If you remember... A few weeks ago. Might be my grand return to Come Through Queen.
Okay.
After my leave.
Flop return.
When we reported on the allegations that Ronge was going to film.
Not allegations. That's not the right word. The reports?
The rumors. Well, I treated them as reports.
The rumors.
You treated them as like just people making up things from their butt.
Okay, continue.
That the Houses of New Jersey would film a non-reunion get-together event at Rails on July 15th, Monday.
And 2 days after my birthday, 2 days after Trump was shot.
And I said, something about this just rings true to me in my heart. I'm not a New Jerseyan, but like I have ties to New Jersey, you know?
I do too. I was conceived there. Beat that, bitch.
Something just felt so right. And Brendan's like, who's saying this? Ronge obsessed.
Because that's who was saying it at the time.
And I said, who better than someone who is obsessed with a show to tell us what is happening. I don't want a fake fan. I want someone who's obsessed. And they delivered. One, Kate Arthur from Variety reports the girls filmed a watch along of the reunion at Rails in separate groups and Dolores Catania floated in between the groups.
Sure.
We had Tree, we had Jen Aiden, and we had Jackie Goldschneider living out her humiliation fantasies in one room.
Okay. So I know you're trying to drag me as a freak here, but what I was doing was being
a journalist.
Not a journalist, but a responsible media watcher and listener. And I'm not going to take Ronj Obsessed's word for it and run with it, because we've seen what happens happens. We've been burned 1,000 times, 1,000,000 times.
But sometimes the burn feels so good.
And so I guess you were quote unquote vindicated, which you like quote tweeted Kate Arthur. And then like she got confused and was like, vindicated? Question mark. And you never answered her.
I did answer her.
Oh. Okay.
I did. Of course I did. Does it not come up when you look at it?
Maybe not. Maybe you're shadow banned. But that brings me to Dan as a freak. Because, and I'm, the clown comes back to bite. So today a Twitter user named Ariana's Minaj tweeted, Kamala girl, I need you to make a bunch of blue hats that say, quote, make America laugh again, quote, unquote. So the abbreviation is MALA, M-L-A, hence your name, and use their card against them. It's now or never, sister. And so, like, Dan did have a similar thesis.
Similar? So, an exact same?
So he quote tweets this. A come-through queen listener, I see. He gets 2 likes. And
that's par for the course.
Ali, a.k.a. Ariana's Minaj, comments right back, not even within the minute, and says, I'm sorry, but I don't know who that is.
Oh my god.
The fact that it was you tweeted that at 5:11, and right at 5:11 she got right back to you.
Well, Ariana's Minaj only has like 1,000 followers. She has all the time in the day.
Okay.
Jeez Louise.
And you've got 1,400.
Oh my god. Okay.
Actually, she has more than you by 7.
Oh, right. She beat me.
She's got 1,420. You've got 1,413.
Cop into it.
So this is if you're listening, go to twitter.com/IDKIDK and follow Dan right now. He needs 8 more followers.
To beat Ariana's Minaj.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
A queen.
So our queen.
Our queen. 2 weeks in a row, a Salt Lake City girl taking the crown.
Yeah. So one Angie K posted a couple like beautiful shots.
Gorgeous shots from
Greece.
From Greece.
She and her caption was, is somebody going to match my Greek?
And I was screaming. My hands were flailing. It's like justice for Tinashe. Brat Summer in effect.
If Rita Wilson and Nia Vardalos don't reach out to Angie K to star in My Big Fat Greek Wedding, what number are we on? 3, 4?
We're going to reboot. We're going to drop the number. And it's just going to be like, My Greek. We're dropping the big, we're dropping the fat, we're dropping the wedding. Just My Greek.
Okay. Is Joey Fatone still allowed to be in it?
He's allowed.
Okay.
As our ambassador, U.S. ambassador to Greece. A lot of people don't know that.
Really?
No.
I was like, for a second, I was like,
All right.
If Sidney McCain can be ambassador of something, then Joey Fatone can.
Yeah, he's
in Kamala's administration.
Well, I could see it. Wow. I think that's the week. As we promote top of episode, Patreon, 2 barn burners, and I think you got a third barn burner right now for free. So why don't you throw us a few bucks at Patreon. Go to comethroughqueen.com for links to that. And just like, comment, subscribe, heart, share, retweet.
Love us, please retweet.
We'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye.
I wanna see ya come through, queen.